Central side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. TCU lines up to kick this one off, and we're just about set to get underway. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Kansas State's coaching staff so confident, they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brett, his big play ability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big playability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute.
And a quick throw. And he tackles him hard at the 33-yard line. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Ready? Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they make the stop around the 42-yard line.
Just another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
Here's a handoff, left side. He tackles him for a loss. From their own 42-yard line, it's second down. He's got it with room to run. Tackle at the 44-yard line.
Tight ends can really be a wild card in any offense. Sometimes the defense are a little bit confused on how to handle them.
Caught open field, out of bounds at the 40. From the 40-yard line, it's second down. Does it complete over the middle? He's tackled at about the 29-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. They'll work the left. He's at the 20. Tackle made at the 16-yard line. From the 16-yard line, first down. And he's tackled at about the 19-yard line. And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. The Wildcats running back down there on the sideline. He was injured earlier. He means a lot to this offense, but I think he's going to be able to come back in. Looks like he's ready to go. Nice run there. A nice 7-yard gain on the option keeper. That'll bring up 36. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Slings it. And he shoved out of bounds at the 6-yard line.
That is just sound fundamental football right there, making it look so easy.
Here's the 12th play of the drive. And down he goes around the 4-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry. From the 4-yard line, second down. Touchdown, K-State. adds the extra point.
A 13-play, 76-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He's to the 20. Brought down at the 25. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Brought down at the 24. From their own 24-yard line. Second down. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
Number three was the intended receiver. Right, 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 that makes it third and 11.
He airs it out. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he's taken down at the 31-yard line.
It definitely put them in better field position. And I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. And he's tackled in the open field. It out to about the 17-yard line.
That makes it 7 and 8.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 17. He's taken down at the 17. Quick strike to the receiver. The 5. And a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They'd love going to him down here.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he tacks on the extra point. A 7-play, 75-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
We get a tie game at 7-7. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. He makes it to the 25-yard line. We've played one. We're even at 7 in this one. We're all tied up, and more action coming, hopefully, here in quarter number 2. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. They'll bring him down right around the 40.
That makes it first and 10.
from their own 40-yard line. First down. He makes his way to about the 45.
Very well-designed play that time to give him a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good gain.
Gets out to around the 35.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second
down. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Fires quickly to the tight end, and they make the stop at the 27-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Now he tries to buy some time. The ball is loose, and the defense picks it up. That's a pretty big mistake, and this offense will lose possession of the football.
Sloppy job by the ball carrier. First and foremost, you should always be concerned about the ball.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. After seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep, those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. Tackle right around the 14-yard line.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
From the 14-yard line, it's first down. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Kansas State gets set to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. And now he's got room to run. He makes his way out to about the 35. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 35. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. He laterals the ball. Makes it to the 44. The running back takes the pitch on the option, and that'll be a pickup of about 9. They come out in a five wide set. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 46. The Horned Frogs running back, he was injured earlier. You see him down there on the sideline, and it looks like he's ready to get back in the game.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
He makes it to the 48-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. He goes out of bounds. Right around the 48-yard line. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Kansas State up 7 points. Zips it to the back, and they got him for a loss. 6 yard setback.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Draw play. Gets to about the 17-yard line. So they get about 3 on the draw. It's 3rd and 13. Ball on the 17. He makes his way out to about the 25.
Sometimes when you think you've got great plays called, the defense just has the answers.
Tackle made at the 42-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. Caught out in the open. He's pushed out of bounds at the 33-yard line. From the 33-yard line, first down. Got a man, watch out here. Steps out of bounds at the 27. Hit immediately. Scrambling around. He's tackled right around the 12-yard line. Here they come. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. He rifles it to the left. This one falls to the turf, incomplete.
These guys, especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. Kicks up, and it is good. TCU lines up for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20, and down he goes at the 22-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even,
And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Kansas State is up four. And they hit him in the backfield. A tight first half of football, and we head to the break. 14-10, Wildcats.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, Dave Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the strip stick, you know, be able to strip the ball out, get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, you know, do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
Boy, I hope the second half's as good as the first. Just about set to start the third quarter in a tight one.
Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Gets out to around the 38.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on the 38. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That brings him second and five.
The 47. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 47. Tackled after a decent pickup.
At the 20, and it's caught.
Tackle made
around the 14-yard line. From the 14-yard line, first down.
Got his receiver, touchdown.
A good football team has to consistently be able to capitalize when they're in the red zone.
Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. And he hits the PAT.
It was a seven-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought
the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 17-14. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Complete. He's got room. He's taken down at the 34.
That's a deep nine on the play. That brings up second and
one. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Hits him hard at the 39.
First down.
Brought down around the 37-yard line.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
Second and 13. Ball on the 37-yard line. Nice run there.
That'll bring up third and six.
And down he goes at the 43. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
That'll make it fourth and six.
He makes it to the 32-yard line. And he was able to pick up some nice yards on the return. The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator got it.
In the air, it's intercepted. And he's taken down around the 47-yard line. He didn't throw it away under pressure, and it really cost him.
It sure did. He saw that he was going to get hit and just threw one up for grabs. He's got to learn to take the sack.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. They'll bring him down right around the 44-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and six.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they make the stop right around the 28-yard line.
That's a gain of 16. That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. Throws this one away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. Tackle at about the 21.
I think he could have taken a risk down the field, but he played it safe instead, and that's one of the keys to winning ball games.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. There he goes. Gets out to around the 9.
That makes it first and 12.
Run, and he's brought down.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That
lines of second and goal.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Three down and one to go. The Horned Frogs with a three-point lead. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. He's going to try and scramble. Touchdown, and they take the lead. He makes the PAT. A seven-play, 47-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Tackle at the 26-yard line.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
Tight ball game, one possession, but they've got an opportunity not only to score and take the lead, but get the momentum going on their side. Throws it deep. A junior makes the catch. He's tackled around the 24-yard line. After the big pass play, we've got a first down. He gets out to about the 14-yard line. Some open field, and he carries the ball for a nice game. So here we go, first and goal, and a field goal won't cut it. He's on the run. He's brought down in the open field. Run here, right side. The defense is trying to protect their lead, but the offense is threatening. It's third down from the three. He's got the corner. He's in. Touchdown. And they take the lead. Run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. And he adds the extra point. TCU is ready to kick it away. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball.
He scrambled, and they get the sack.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Looking to dig themselves out of a little hole here after the sack. It's second and 14.
36 to Mike. Ready?
Now he tries to buy some time. He's out to the 30, and he's tackled
at about the 37-yard line. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Nice run to the outside.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That brings them second and 5.
From their own 42-yard line, second down. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He gets hit out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
Gain of 10 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
It out to about the 47-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 47. Receiver's got it on the screen. And he's leveled at the 37-yard line.
Number 25 on the tackle at the 37-yard line. First down.
He's scrambling, and he's going to be sacked.
The offensive line has to at least slow the guy down a little bit. He was in there in no time.
That brings up second and 13.
So that sack sets him back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. Complete. He's got space to work. Tackle made around the 29-yard line.
Number 16 brings him down at the 29-yard line.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Just over a minute left. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Wildcats taking their first time out of the half. It's first and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. They give to the tailback. Makes it to the 14. This guy just made those 10 yards look easy. Here's the 11th play of the drive. The Wildcats are going to call their second timeout. Slings it. He's taken down at the 8-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. They try to get a head start there.
False start. Offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still second down.
From the 8-yard line, it's second down. He's hit before he can go anywhere. That'll be a pickup of a yard.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. So they bring out the kicker to tie this game up. A make will most likely mean overtime, a miss, and well, that's it. The kick is away, and it's good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Late here in the fourth quarter now in a tie football game, and it looks like, barring another score, we might be headed to overtime. Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
This looks like their last shot to get it to the end zone.
Well, the player of the game might come from the defense after that stop here late in the fourth quarter. That could be the turning point.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Bring him down at the 46. And that's the end of the fourth quarter, and we're going to take this deadlock into overtime. Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime. Gets to about the 24-yard line. From the 24-yard line, second down. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. It out to about the 7. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Steps out at the 3-yard line. Brought down around the 3-yard line. So here we go. It's third and goal, and they're trying to break the tie.
Now let's see if you can respond. Great teams always find a way to come through.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Down, and they need to get it to the 15. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Got a man. Watch out here. He goes out of bounds around the 21-yard line. So this one's final. Very well played by both teams today. TCU 31, Kansas State 24. So that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.